In the last two videos, we talked about minerals. Well, minerals, when they group together, form rocks, and there are three types of rocks. Igneous rocks form from molten rock. Think of lava flowing out of a volcano on Hawaii. That's a good example of an igneous rock. A second type of rock is a sedimentary rock, which is composed of particles of rocks or minerals, like sand grains on a beach or sand in a river. And then the third type of rock are metamorphic rocks, and these form by high heat, pressure, and chemical change. Now, all of these three types of rocks are connected by the rock cycle, as you can see in this graphic. We'll start with igneous rocks, which start off as molten lava. The molten rock comes to the surface, forms a lava, and it hardens and it becomes a rock. After time, however, what's going to happen to that rock? Well, those external processes we talked about start to act on and break apart the rocks. And you produce sediment that is then carried in a river to the ocean to, say, to a beach. And it produces a sedimentary rock like a sandstone. So we go from igneous rock to sedimentary rock. But then if we bury that sandstone deep within the earth, as it gets deeper, it gets hotter, there's higher pressure, and you change it into a metamorphic rock. The metamorphism is caused by heat and pressure. If you continue to heat that rock, what will happen to it? It will melt and become a magma or molten rock again, and then it will rise up to the surface and form another lava or another igneous rock. So that's where the cycle comes in. And there's not only one path to the cycle. As you can see from the graphic, there are other kinds of pathways that rocks can follow. For example, a igneous rock can be buried and it can change into a metamorphic rock and then it can melt. Now let's talk a little bit about how the rock cycle is related to plate tectonics. Remember, in plate tectonics, there's a divergent plate boundary. That's where hot molten rock comes up in the middle of the oceans. And it forms an igneous rock. It's then carried to the continents on the plate and it's subducted underneath the plate. It heats up and it melts part of that rock, and that magma, molten rock, that's what magma is, rises and eventually forms a volcano, and you may get a lava. And then the external processes operate on that lava, break it down, wear it down. You break the rock up, you produce sand grains. The sand grains are carried by rivers to the ocean. And then in the ocean, perhaps these sand grains will be carried out to deeper water into what's called the subduction zone, and then will be carried underneath the continent again, and they will melt, and they'll rise up, and you form an igneous rock again. So there's, you see, the cycle as related to plate tectonics.